Here we are at 5 weeks old with Snowflake and Burton's babies. Yeah. What do you think, huh? Green has a love-hate relationship with the camera. As soon as I turn it off, he runs up, and now he's not sure. He's like, I want to get close. I don't know about it. Come on. Come see mommy. Yes. Here's our little blue guy. He's the smallest of what we have available. Yeah. Hi. Hi. I love it. Yeah. Come here. And then here's our purple girl who has our little white markings. Come on over here. You gonna play ball? Are you gonna play ball? And so the big kahunas of the litter, and they don't, it's not really visible, but when you pick them up, you can tell, is green boy right here and our pink girl. They are big kahunas. And that's not part of your hair, that's fuzz. And little purple girl here and yellow and blue. Blue's probably the smallest here. And here's our yellow baby. Say hi. Come on out. Oh, I gotta reach. Come on out. Yeah. Yellow is our tail wagging happy dude. Yeah. You're always happy. So just kind of typical to their temperament, they are very laid back. And I'm going to contribute this to our English lines. I have just noticed this about our English lines. And you know, certain mamas, their disposition comes through too. So for, you know, Snowflake, she is just the sweetest thing ever. Never going to get a growl out of that dog, that's for sure. When I think about it, you know, most of our dogs don't growl. Sometimes they will growl if they are up against another mama and think that maybe she's going to take their babies. That's happened before when they're in the middle of labor and a mama comes up to sniff around the box and they're like, hey, listen, I have to admit I was probably that way when I was giving birth too. But anywho, these guys are just kind of laid back and sweet. Yeah. Say hi. Are you going to roll over for us? So for those who haven't heard, my girls call these the potatoes. Yeah. Right now, yes, they're probably their favorite just because they're in a playful stage right now. They're a little more playful than the other puppies. So once the other puppies get a little more playful, then they'll become a favorite too. But we have done our temperament testing and those results are just waiting for me to go ahead and type them up. It's what I put together is a mixture of the results that we take from our testing, and then I mix them with, we have a sit down with everybody in the family. I actually probably value that more than any test that we've ever done. Excuse me, guys, is to just see what everybody in the family thinks, assess every puppy. Because our kids have grown up in this. We are going on 14 years. So we have children 20, 16, 15, 13, 9, and then of course the babies. And so they've been doing this a long time and they really do understand personality, temperament, and they have their reasons for liking some. In the olden days, it used to just be because of their collar color, but now they really actually do have favorites. So sitting down, getting their assessment on each puppy. And it can be hard when you have some litters like this, which are all incredibly sweet, all incredibly mild, really don't seem to have a energetic person in this one, or overly energetic. So I really value what they say. So we sit around in the living room, we have our scorecards, we go through, everybody tells us the good, bad, ugly, pros, cons, things that they like, and then we ask them specific questions. And that's actually where I really get my assessment, is based on that. Of course, when we're doing our service and therapy, we look at those scorecards to really help out our individuals there. To my knowledge, I don't believe anybody in this litter is actually